Hey guys, welcome back. So today we are going to talk all about Thanksgiving picture books, my favorite titles that I'm going to include in this year's Thanksgiving book basket. So grab some coffee and let's talk books. So Thanksgiving is my absolute favorite holiday. Fall is my favorite season and I love to cook. So I love all of the food. I love being together with our family. I love the focus on thankfulness and gratitude. So it's probably not surprising that Thanksgiving is what inspired our very first book basket here in the Ralston household. One November when my oldest kids were just toddlers, I think Noah and Leah were maybe 2 and 3, we headed to our local library and they had a Thanksgiving book display on one of their walls. And the kids and I, we just went a little nuts. We filled our entire library bag full of Thanksgiving picture books and brought them home. And I just stashed all of them in a basket on our fireplace. And that was our very first seasonal book basket. That basket turned into a Christmas basket that then turned into a Valentine's basket, which then turned into a spring themed basket. And so a themed book basket was born in our household and has been going strong ever since. Now, even if you are not a homeschooler, you can create book baskets for your kids. It is just such a wonderful way to encourage reading in your children and kind of give you the encouragement to read aloud to them a little bit more often. No matter if you have babies or toddlers or even middle schoolers and high schoolers, my oldest, who is 13, still loves to look through all of these picture books, especially the ones that go around the holidays. So no matter how old your kids are, try doing a book basket in your home. I promise you will not regret that you did. Now, before I jump into each of the titles that I want to tell you about today, I do want to mention that this is actually part 2 of a 2-part series about Thanksgiving here on my channel. I will make sure to link part 1 down below, where I shared a review of a Thanksgiving unit study put out by Campfire Curriculums. So today, all of the picture books that I'm going to share with you actually line up really well with the 10 lessons that are in that unit study. So how I will do this today, I will go through all of the books just like I normally do and give you a summary. And then if you are interested in a more thorough breakdown about how each book correlates with the different lessons in Campfire Curriculums, I will make sure to leave that information down below in the description box, as well as on my website, which I will link below. Okay, so let's just jump in and see all of the books that I have in our basket for this fall. First up is The Turkey Bowl. And this is my son Noah's absolute favorite Thanksgiving book. He loves this and it's no wonder why. Boys will love this book. It is all about the Turkey Bowl, an annual football game that Ethan's family plays every single year. And you will follow along and see how the different weather conditions really affect their Turkey Bowl game, whether it has been rain or fog or even this year, snow. Ethan is so disappointed when he wakes up on Thanksgiving morning to find out that they have had so much snow that his extended family members, his aunts and uncles and cousins, are not going to be able to make it for Thanksgiving, which means they are going to have to cancel their annual football game. As you can imagine, there is a happy ending to this book, but I will let you read it for yourself to find out. Next up, we have This Is the Feast, and this is actually the very first Thanksgiving book that I ever purchased for my kids, probably about a decade ago. This book is full of lyrical, poetry-like text that is just so fun to read. And it pairs so well with beautiful illustrations that talk all about the pilgrims coming over on the Mayflower in the 1620s. It talks all about how they first settled in the Americas and how they met Squanto and how they prepared for that very first Thanksgiving feast. This is just a very classic Thanksgiving book. It is one of our absolute favorites. Now, I don't think I can create a book basket without including a book from Anne Rockwell, and this is Thanksgiving Day. This is the story of Mrs. Maddox's class as they are putting on a Thanksgiving play. Charlie dresses up as a ship, Sarah as a pilgrim, Pablo as Squanto, and they talk about what each of these different characters are thankful for. And Rockwell books are great if you have toddlers or preschoolers in particular. Her writing is just so engaging, especially for that age group. So I can't recommend Anne Rockwell enough. Speaking of Squanto, next up we have Squanto's Journey, the story of the first Thanksgiving. And this book is great, especially if you have older kids. It is a little bit of a longer picture book, but it gives you so much information, so much historical facts about Squanto. It gives the Thanksgiving timeline and story from his perspective rather than from the pilgrims. You see how he fights for peace and for friendship and for trade and for the good of his people. Now, if you have older children, I would definitely recommend for you to read the author's note that is in the back of the book. It really gives his perspective about why he wrote the book and how he got the information that he did. And my older kids just really enjoyed listening to that piece of the story. Now, we are big Sarah Hale fans in our house, and so I actually have two different books about her to share with you today. First, I have Sarah Gives Thanks. This book tells the story of the widowed mother of five, Sarah Hale, and her talented writing and persistent spirit that lead to Thanksgiving finally becoming a national holiday. Sarah Hale is a wonderful example, especially if you have daughters in your house. Again, on the last page of the book, there is an author's note that gives great information if you have older kids that you want to read this book to as well. Now, if you have boys, they may appreciate this next one a little bit more. It is called Thank You, Sarah, the Woman Who Saved Thanksgiving. The book has just a very comical, humorous type of writing style, as well as just these really intricate and different illustrations that my boys just love. They love the idea of a superhero and just this woman being depicted as saving the day. It is full of facts and historical information about Sarah Hale, her writing career, and her legacy. Again, there is extra information on the last few pages of this book that provide you with a feast of facts, as they call it, giving you lots more information about Sarah Hale and what was going on in our country. Both of these books about Sarah Hale will definitely encourage and inspire your children to write, to take their writing seriously and think strongly about the power behind the pen. This next book has animals as characters. This is called A Turkey for Thanksgiving. And this is a story about Mr. and Mrs. Moose as they are preparing for Thanksgiving and are in search for a turkey for their Thanksgiving table. Mr. Moose goes out for a walk on a search for a turkey for his wife. As he strolls along, he is joined by his friends, a rabbit, sheep, goats, porcupine, all kinds of just wonderful characters that help him finally hunt down a turkey for Thanksgiving. This book definitely has a little bit of a surprise ending that your children will just definitely love. So A Turkey for Thanksgiving, check it out. So I don't know if this is true for you in your part of the country, but our library has been busier than ever. I feel like it's been harder to get those books this year than in years past. But one book that I wanted to share with you today that I don't actually physically have to show you is Balloons Over Broadway. I tried to get this from the library. I tried to order it online. It has been out of stock everywhere. So what I ended up doing instead was actually pulling up a YouTube video for my kids, a storytime YouTube video that I will make sure to link down below. So since I could not find the book this year, what I did instead was I pulled up a YouTube video for my kids, a virtual storytime, as you would say, for them to hear and see the story about the immigrant and puppeteer Tony Sarg, who inspired the helium balloons in the Macy's Day Parade. This book is just a wonderful biography about him and just provides so much history behind the parade and just, you know, that iconic tradition that so many of us have on Thanksgiving morning. So lesson 6 in the Thanksgiving unit from Campfire Curriculums involves poetry. So I have a couple of Thanksgiving poetry books to share with you today. First up is It's Thanksgiving by Jack Prulezki. And Jack Prulezki is one of our favorite poets here in the Ralston House. This book has 12 Thanksgiving poems along with some illustrations to go with each one. Actually, a few years ago on Thanksgiving, Noah memorized one of his Thanksgiving poems titled I Ate Too Much and recited it before our Thanksgiving dinner. So I thought it would just be fun to share that poem with you guys today. I ate too much. I ate too much turkey. I ate too much corn. I ate too much pudding and pie. I'm stuffed up with muffins and much too much stuffing. I'm probably going to die. I piled up my plate and I ate, but I wish I had known when to stop. For I'm so crammed with yams, sauces, gravies, and jams that my buttons are starting to pop. I'm full of tomatoes and French fried potatoes. My stomach is swollen and sore, but there's still some dessert. So I guess it won't hurt if I eat just a little bit more. The other poetry book that is actually new to us this year in our house is Thanksgiving Day at Our House, Thanksgiving Poems for the Very Young. This book has 15 Thanksgiving poems for younger children. They are simple and fun with beautiful illustrations. It actually also includes several prayer style poems. Thank you, God, for bugs, prayers for others. And I think that these poems are great in particular if you have toddlers through elementary school age kids in your house. The next book on our list is Thanksgiving Graces. This is a story about a little boy who is helping out in the kitchen as they are preparing Thanksgiving dinner. However, as they are hard at work, several unexpected guests arrive, and soon the little boy starts to worry that they are not going to have enough food for everyone. This is a great story about hospitality and always having enough room, always having something to share when you have someone new come into your home. And it even refers to Jesus and the miracle of the loaves and fishes. This is a new book to us this year, so I just really enjoyed it. I think this will be a keeper for sure. I absolutely love the cover of this book. It reminds me of Ezra. This is The Thanksgiving Bowl. And this is a story about a bowl that Grandma uses every year to collect slips of paper from her family that detail what they are thankful for. And the family kind of plays a little bit of a guessing game, trying to figure out who wrote each slip of paper. This year, the Thanksgiving bowl is accidentally left outside and it rolls away. And you follow along to watch where it ends up each month of the year. It is a hat for a snowman, a home for tadpoles, even a toy in a sandbox. I'm sure it will be no surprise to you that the Thanksgiving bowl comes full circle and it arrives back in Grandma Grace's yard just in time for the following Thanksgiving for them to do their tradition all over again. The next two books I'm going to share with you are definitely great for toddlers. The first is a board book here. It is called Thankful, and it is a very simple story that goes through and talks about different professions and what that person in that profession could be thankful for. So for instance, a gardener is thankful for sprouts. A poet is thankful for rhyming words. An artist is thankful for color and light. And so I just really love the different perspectives of different careers in this book. And because it is short and to the point and also a board book, it is just great for your babies and your toddlers. Along that same vein of being thankful, we have Thanks for Thanksgiving, and it is all about thankfulness. Thankfulness centered around family. As a homeschool mama, I love that there is even a page that says thank you for school. I love to feel smart. Thank you for music and dancing and art. Thank you for play dates, for swings, and for slides. It has a really great short rhyming text, and just the illustrations are the star of the show. There is even a place in the back of the book that gives you a spot to journal what your child is thankful for this year. I think that this would be really fun just to maybe write one or two items with your child every year and create a list as you read this book year after year in your book basket. This next book is again new to us this year. This is called The Memory Cupboard, A Thanksgiving Story. And this is one that my girls in particular, my elementary and middle school girls, are really enjoying. This is the story of a Thanksgiving dinner where Katie accidentally breaks the gravy boat, and not just any gravy boat, a treasured dish in their house. And she, like any young girl, is just embarrassed and humiliated that she accidentally broke this. But her grandmother lovingly takes her in and shows her the memory cupboard, a collection of broken toys and items that she has kept, objects from years past that have all collected wonderful stories and wonderful memories that her grandmother holds near and dear to her heart. This book is a great story about making mistakes and cherishing family memories. This is The Thanksgiving Treat by Catherine Stock, and it is a story about a young child who is feeling left out on Thanksgiving Day. A little boy travels from one room to the next all over the house, trying to find a way that he can help prepare for Thanksgiving. Everyone in the family is hard at work, and there is just no job that is the right size for him. But thankfully, Grandpa to the rescue takes him for a walk, and they find the best Thanksgiving treat of all, a basket full of chestnuts to roast over the fire. Now, I use this book to connect with the campfire curriculum's lesson about the cornucopia or a horn of plenty. I think that you can connect this basket full of walnuts to just a basket overflowing with plenty. Now, this next book is not quite a picture book that you read aloud, but I think it is great in our basket nonetheless. It is A Thanksgiving Drawing Feast. And this is just a great book that can help your kids draw very simple Thanksgiving illustrations. First of all, they can draw a cornucopia, but they can also do a turkey, a pumpkin patch, even a character running for a touchdown. It has very simple step-by-step drawing instructions, and my younger kids just really enjoy using this during the month of November. The last book in our book basket this year is Thanksgiving in the Woods, and this was actually recommended in Lesson 10 in the Thanksgiving unit from Campfire Curriculum. This is a picture book depicting the real-life tradition of a family in New York who gathers every year for Thanksgiving meal in the woods. This is a book that just might inspire you to consider eating outdoors this year yourself. If anyone in your family is musical, at the back of the book there is a song, Simple Gifts, that honestly you could play very easily on a piano or with any instrument really. So that's back there if you're interested in that. Now, just as a bonus, I wanted to share a couple of early reader chapter books that you could include in a Thanksgiving basket. First up, we have Nate the Great Talks Turkey. This is just a great detective series. Then we also have What Was the First Thanksgiving? This is part of the Who Was or What Was series. Magic Treehouse number 27, Thanksgiving on Thursday. And then we have the Imagination Station, Problems in Plymouth. This is from the creators of Adventures in Odyssey and Focus on the Family. And then lastly, Rush Revere and the Brave Pilgrims. So if you have early readers in your house, you could work on reading these aloud to them or letting them read them aloud to you. That could be really fun. Even my middle schoolers just really enjoy being able to pick up a quick and easy read like this that is themed around Thanksgiving. The other bonus that I wanted to share with you homeschool mamas out there are just a few titles that I myself am enjoying reading during the month of November. I desperately enjoy reading picture books with my kids, but I also have a few books that I like to read around the Thanksgiving season. The first one, and my absolute favorite one, is 1,000 Gifts, A Dare to Live Fully Right Where You Are, and this is by Anne Voskamp. And I just cannot say enough about this book. It will encourage you to be more thankful than you ever thought you could be. She has such a unique and beautiful writing style. Just buy this book, you will love it. Another book that I grab often during the Thanksgiving season is Choosing Gratitude, Your Journey to Joy by Nancy Leigh DeMoss, who is now actually Nancy Leigh DeMoss Wugglemuth. I'm sorry, Nancy, I'm butchering your last name. But this book is wonderful. It will really help you to think through how you are choosing gratitude on a daily basis. It even has a 30-day devotional in the back of the book, and it has a foreword by Johnny Erickson Tada, which I know so many of you just love, love, love her. So if you've never read this book, I would definitely encourage you to give it a look. And then the last book that I really enjoy reading this type of year, which I'm actually doing on audiobook this time around, is the George Mueller biography. It is just such a wonderful story about contentment and relying on God to meet all of our needs. So homeschool mamas, if you are out there just needing a good book to read this November, I would definitely encourage you to pick up one of these books. Okay guys, well that is it for today. I hope you enjoyed all of the picture books that we are including in our Thanksgiving book basket this year, as well as those few bonus chapter books for your kids and for yourself. Like I said, if you are interested in seeing how I fleshed out each of these books to coordinate with the Campfire Curriculum's Thanksgiving unit study, just check out the notes down below in the description box or head over to my website, everydayhomeschooler.com. As always, guys, if you enjoyed today's video, please give it a thumbs up, like it down below, and while you're there, hit the red subscribe button and subscribe to our channel. Also, leave me a comment. Tell me what your favorite Thanksgiving picture book or chapter book is. I would love to hear about it and have some new titles to add to our basket next year. All right, guys, well, I hope that you are enjoying November and getting ready for Thanksgiving with your family. I pray that this season is just such a blessing to all of you. See you later.